This is all God's doing, man, you can't plan it. But if the devil's in the details, then I'm satanic. About to take over your city and you can't stand it. My account say you sinking like the Titanic. David Blaine last summer, man, you had to vanish. I get a hiss like somebody.
What's Gucci, my hoochies? It is Cat Wilderness here, and I am back at it again with another video. I know you're probably like, girl, you haven't made a video in centuries, and I know. I know. I'm like the best YouTuber, guys. Like, let me tell you, like, they should just give me all the awards because I know I'm the bombest YouTuber. And I've only done like one makeup video on here, and a lot of people have told me that I should do more makeup videos. So here y'all go. I'ma bless y'all with another makeup video. Let me tell you, makeup beauty guru, yes. JK, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing, but you know, if you here for the ride, I'm here for the ride. So right now I have my whole makeup set up right in front of me, and today we are going to do my go-to makeup glam. So this glam is like my easy glam. This is the one I'm most comfortable with, and I think it looks the best on me. Okay, so let me stop talking and let's get into this video. So what I start out doing first is I moisturize my skin with the Nivea Men Sensitive Post Shave Balm. This is bomb as fuck. This is amazing. If you've seen any makeup artist or anybody on YouTube do their makeup, they have probably used this. I just put it all over my face, and I just like to feel very moisturized, so I kind of douse myself in it. I don't know if that's how you're supposed to do it, but that's the way I do it. So after that's done, I am gonna put this back. And I'm going to be using this amazing fucking primer. Y'all, like, if you don't know, now you know. This Smashbox Photo Finish Primer is everything. It makes your makeup look bomb as fuck. It makes your skin looks like bomb as fuck. So I don't know how beauty gurus do it, but this is what I recommend. I definitely recommend they also have a smaller version, which is cheaper than this one, which I didn't know about. And if I would have known about it, I would have gone the cheaper route. And this is oil free. So if you are oily like me, this is perfect for you. I've been told that I put too much primer on, but I'm just like, can you ever put too much of makeup on in general? Yes, you can. That answer is yes, you can. But I don't abide by everyone's rules because I'm a rule breaker and I'm edgy. I'm a drama channel. I'm just kidding. Don't come for me, drama channels. Please don't. So I like to use my fingers to just blend it out. I know some makeup artists are probably like, what? Use a brush. I'm like, no. So after I prepped and primed my skin, I go in with my NARS All Day Luminous Foundation. Y'all, this foundation, I just bought it about 2 days ago, but I've had it before. This is my favorite foundation ever. To date, this is my favorite foundation. Y'all, if y'all don't know, this is the shit. It makes my skin, like, once it's all done, it just makes it look so amazing. If you don't know, now you know. So, okay, so I like to take this and I like to put about, like, 3 pumps. I like to start out with, like, 3 pumps on the back of my hand, and then I take my pinky finger and I just go in. Now, I like to put a lot of foundation on, even though, I mean, like, I don't have the worst skin in the world. I just like a lot of foundation, and I like that look. And I mean, like, not everyone is a fan of that look. It's so funny because I did a, like, everyday makeup tutorial, like, last year. And it was before I, like, knew how to, like, semi-do makeup. Because I don't know how to do makeup, but I know how to do, like, my face, and I know how to make my face look a little bit decent. Oh. I did my mom's lashes, with the lashes that I'm gonna use for this video, and she's just like, are you sure they're not too long? And I'm like, no, that's the point of lashes. They're supposed to look like you're wearing, like you have long lashes. Okay, so I think I have enough foundation. Do y'all think I have enough foundation on? I don't think so. No, just kidding. This is good. This is about the amount I put on. So I take my beauty blender, which is damp, because if you don't use a damp beauty blender, it's not gonna look great, according to every single beauty guru on YouTube. So I do it because I like to follow trends, and I don't like to be original, right? So I like to take my beauty blender, damp it, and then just go to town and like beat the face. And we're beating. Hopefully we have a black eye by the time we're done. That's the goal. So y'all, like, I bought this mirror for $5 from a garage sale. It's bomb as fuck. It has a light, it has a close-up mirror, and then it has like two side mirrors, and it has a light. Girl, so good. So good. I'm always for cheap and cheerful. Always for cheap and cheerful. Because that's what I am. Cheap and cheerful. Oh, I make myself laugh because I have no friends and I'm a loser. It's okay. But I'm a proud loser. Like, I'm proud to be one. So a lot of people like to do their eyes before they put on foundation, which is a little bit strange to me. I like to like work my way up and then down. Like, I'm gonna start on my eyebrows, and then I'm gonna start on my eyes, and then I'm gonna do my like full face. And I think I'm supposed to do my eyes and eyebrows last. That's not the way I do it, and I wanna be authentic. So I'm just gonna keep doing it and stop talking. Now I'm going to start on my eyebrows. And what I use for my eyebrows is, okay, so do not judge me. This is very dirty, I understand. But it's what I use like for every day, so it's whatever. Don't act like y'all's makeup is like prim and perfect every single time. Because I know it ain't. So what I use for my eyebrows is I use the Anastasia Dip Brow, like every single other person in the world, in the shade medium brown. And I just have found that medium brown is the perfect color for my skin tone. And as you can see, I basically have used a lot of it. I don't know if you could see that. I just take it with an angled brush and I just start going to town. Now, I like thick brows. I like personally thick brows. It's not for everyone. Like, I like a makeup look. And that's the makeup look I'm going for, so I don't know why I'm apologizing. I shouldn't apologize. Yes. I feel like if your brows aren't touching your temples, then you're doing it wrong. Okay, so what I do next with my brows is I actually take my Morphe palette, which is also very dirty. Don't judge me, but I know you always will. And I like to take this color right here. And I use the same brush, and I just like to fill it in just so it's more intense, or just it can set it, you know? Maybe that makes sense, maybe it doesn't. Makes sense to me. Which probably means that it will not make sense to you, because a lot of things that make sense to me do not make sense to a lot of other people. It's so funny, like, I watch my videos, like, this is like honest, like, true tea. Like, I watch my videos, and I think I still sound like a man, and it's like sucks because I get comments sometimes like, you still sound like a man. Like, what is, like, are you going through like therapy, or you're taking hormones, or like, I'm still not taking hormones, which is very, very risky, because someone my age that is trans should probably start taking hormones by now. But 2017 is gonna be the year I start taking hormones. I can't wait, honestly. Okay, so the thing is that I always do amazing on this brow. I still need to fill it a little bit, but that's okay, I'll fix it in a minute. I always do really good on this brow, but I never do good on this brow. It sucks. But it's okay, I can always fix it. I can always make it just bigger. Big brows never hurt nobody. I like a big-browed bitch. Like me. I always notice, like, I fuck up whenever I'm filming, but, like, whenever I'm not filming, I do perfectly fine. I don't know. You guys make me feel so pressured. Pressured to be perfect. JK, nobody's perfect. And I'm far from perfect. Very, 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 very far from perfect. I don't even think I can see perfect from where I am. So the brows are finished. Now, let's move on to the eyes. Because you know what they say, the eyes are the window to your pussy. Well, I know it's soul, but at least the eyes are the window to my pussy. Okay, so I'm gonna put this back, and then I'm going to get my primer for my eyes. And the primer that I use is the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in the primer color, I don't know, Eden. And that's actually a name of one of my favorite trans girls. She's actually on YouTube, if you wanna check her out, Eden Doll. Love you, girl. I doubt you're watching this, but if you happen to ever see this, I love you, girl, so much. Someone tweet this to Eden or tag Eden in this so she could see it. I would love that. Personally, like, beautiful. She's a goddess. Love her. Okay, so I'm going to take my primer and I'm going to, hopefully, my fat isn't showing. Whatever. If it is, you know, this is the real me. This is real. This is me. Okay, so I'm just going to take it and I'm going to put it on the middle of my eyelid. I just take my pinky and I just move it around. Blend it. Okay, so I'm going to take my brush and get my Morphe palette back out. While I put that away. So I'm going to use this color right here. It's the whitest color. After I put that on my eyelids, I like to take my blending brush, which is semi-broken, and I take this color right here, which is like a brown color. It's not a brown color, it's brown, bitch. So this is, I like this color because it's like a reddish brown. This is the Morphe 350 palette, by the way. I didn't say the palette, and I feel like everyone has this palette, and if you don't, girl, get it right now. Like, it's only $20 on the Morphe site. And when I found that out, I was like, oh, you have to be kidding me. Like, I thought this shit was gonna be like a $40 palette, like the Kylie palette. I want the Kylie palette, don't get me wrong. The peach, oh my God, girl. That peach palette, I want that so bad. So if anyone wants to send me that, I'm just kidding. Okay, and then I go in again with the same brush that I used with a red color that is like a deep red. Right here, and I just do in the same place. Blend, blend, blend. And what I've learned, from like blending and everything like that, and I didn't learn this from YouTube, is that I feel like this is maybe common sense. I don't know. If it is, then I'm just stupid. But whenever I'm getting my brushes, I find it most easiest to blend when I just like tap the eyeshadow like once. And then go in and just build it up like that. Because I found that if you like dig in there and then start doing it, it's just not cute. I just wanted someone to like look at my everyday makeup video that I did like last year. And then look at my makeup now when it's all done. The difference is astonishing. Astonishing? Astonishing? Is that the word? I don't know. So next I move on to the eyeliner. And what I use for my eyeliner is this. You can't even see it anymore, but this is the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner. I love this so much. It's just so perfect for eyeliner and it's very easy to apply. And I'm going to be right back because I have to focus on this shit. So I don't want to mess up. So I will be right back and hopefully when you see me, I will have bomb eyeliner. Okay, so as you can see, my eyeliner is now as tight as my pussy hole. Actually, I'm not kidding about that. But, so, next, I'm going to take actually the brush that I used for my, the white on my eyes, not under my eyes, and I'm going to brush it off. And I'm going to take my Naked 2 palette and I'm going to go in the color Half Baked right here. And I'm just going to dab into that and I'm going to put it right here on my, or under my brow bone, or on my brow bone, if that makes sense. And this, honestly, is the best fucking highlight I could ever ask for. Just so bomb. I don't know if you can see that. Maybe. It's just really, really the best. Yes. Okay. And then I'm gonna go in with that color, and I'm also going to go and just go in the corner of my eyes and actually go into Chopper as well and go in right there as well. So it gives it like a rose goldy effect. So next, before I do my my waterline and under my eyes and mascara and lashes and all that, I like to move on to my concealer. Finally, I know. So what I use for my concealer, it's really dirty. Sorry, I'm just, all my makeup is dirty because this is what I use. I'm sorry. Like, don't judge me. Don't come for me. is the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation and Concealer. So I take it and I just put it on the back of my hand. I don't put a lot yet. I just like to do it in very small amounts. So I'm going to go in with my brush that is from e.l.f. I'm going to take this. There's a little bit of hair on that. We're not gonna put that in the edit, but knowing me, I'm just gonna put that in the edit because I hate myself. And then I'm gonna go in and I'm just gonna conceal my imperfections. Now, as you know, I like a makeup look. Like, I like to look like I'm wearing makeup, so I put a lot of concealer on. After I'm done with that, I take this Wet n Wild brush. I take this Wet n Wild brush and I put in the concealer and I just go in my nose because I want to look like I have a small nose. And I don't like to put concealer right here because I just like to keep it right here. And I have, by the way, I have a mirror right here, and right here. So if you're wondering why I'm like looking right here, or looking right here, or looking right here, it's because I have mirrors all around me right now. So I'm gonna get my damp beauty blender and I'm just gonna blend this out. When in doubt, blend that shit fucking out. If you got a fuck boy in your life, blend it out. So after I am all concealed out, I like to move on to contouring. And what I use for my contour is my Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette, which is very fucking dirty. So I'm gonna go in with my Wet n Wild brush and I'm going to put this in here. I'm just gonna contour those cheeks, girl. Okay, and then I take my beauty blender and I just blend out the harshness. Okay, so now it's time to set my concealer. So what I use is I use the Airspun Translucent Face Powder in the color Translucent Extra Coverage. Now, bomb. Gotta get that. Y'all gotta get this shit. If y'all like real... And I'm just gonna set it. Set that shit, girl. If you find a man and that dick really bomb, set that shit, girl. Make sure that boy ain't going nowhere. Like, this makeup ain't going nowhere. Okay, and while that sits, I'm gonna take my fluffy brush and I'm going to go in, actually, with my Morphe palette. And I'm gonna take the light brown shade and I'm just gonna tap it. That's it. And use this as a powder setter for my contour. And I don't like to contour my chin just because I already have a defined chin. So I don't really contour my chin or under my chin. So now that it's been a minute or two, I like to go in with a fluffy brush. This is my e.l.f. fluffy contour brush, but I like to use it just to wipe away my translucent powder. And I just brush away that shit. If you got a real fuckboy in your life, just brush him away. Brush that shit to the side. Start putting on my eyelashes. Now, the eyelashes that I use, actually, is the individual eyelashes because I've found that this is so much better. For me, personally, it's not for everyone, but for me personally, this is my favorite way to put on falsies because it gives me the opportunity to build it up. And this is just bomb. This is bomb, y'all. Like, y'all don't, Y'all gotta get into it. Get into it. Just gonna pick one by one and do these eyelashes. So I'm gonna fast forward this because this video will be literally like 50 minutes long if I did that, because this takes so long. So I will be back and hopefully I will be lusciously eyelashed. Okay, so I wanted to show you guys the difference. This is lashes. This is no lashes. Lashes. No lashes. See a difference? Little bit. I don't know. I really like these lashes. Honestly, I think they're just so much easier than putting on the strip lashes. But then again, it could be harder for some people. So, yeah. God, my lips look so crusty. Like my life. Y'all, this is no way sponsored, but girl, these Thin Mint cookies, please, Girl Scouts, please sponsor me, because I would definitely, gladly accept that sponsorship. This is like an ASMR video, a little bit. Now that I have my lashes on, I'm going to move on to my waterline. What I use for my waterline, I'm almost out of it. Do not laugh at me. But I use this, more hair. I have a lot of it. I use this e.l.f. Just eyeliner pencil. So after I put the black under my eyes. So after I do my waterline, I go back into the Urban Decay Naked 2 palette, and I take my brush and I just pack on more gold. Then after that, I take my actually Naked 2 brush that it comes with. I go in with this company. I forgot this company, but I'll put it in the description below. I bought this eyeshadow and it's pretty bomb, honestly. And it was only like $2 from Etsy, actually. So it's like an independent company, and I support independent makeup companies. So always support independent makeup companies because they matter too. It's literally just straight pigment. And I just take the flat top part of the brush, just dab that in there, and go to town. I think it just gives it a nice pop of color. Okay, and we're almost done. Is this recording? Please tell me this fucking shit is recording. Hopefully. Yes. Okay, so the second to last step is my favorite part, is highlighting. Before I get onto lips, I go to highlighting. So for my highlighter, I'm going to take my e.l.f. brush. E.l.f. brushes, y'all, if y'all don't got some e.l.f. brushes, y'all sleeping. Like, e.l.f. brushes are pretty great. I figured that out when I... Hello there. So, little problemo. My camera died, so now I am on my phone. So, before anything bad happens, let me finish this up. So, like I was saying, I'm going to be highlighting. And I'm going to use the Jeffree Star So Fucking Gold. If you saw my review on it, I did a review on it. I will put that in the description below if you want to check that out. But girl, this fucking highlight is everything. So let's get to highlighting. Girl, ugh, just putting on a little, like, just takes me to the stars, girl. And I use two different highlighters, actually. Sometimes I use three if I'm feeling fucking extra. But look at that highlight, that glow. Can you spot it? So after I put on So Fucking Gold, I put on the Urban, hold on, there's tape on here. Let me not be a messy ass bitch. So after I go in with the Jeffree Star So Fucking Gold, I go in with the Urban Decay Naked Illuminated highlighter. I don't know why I said between all those words, but I go in with this. I take the same brush, and it gives me a very, very rose goldy effect that I live for. Live for, honey. For the last part, my favorite fucking part is the lips. So what I use for my lips is I use my favorite of all time lipstick, or liquid lipstick. My Kat Von D Lolita. I mean, it's just classic. Everyone knows it. And it's just iconic. I take a deep breath before I do this because I like to draw them very big. I don't know how a lot of people are going to feel about this, but before I put on my lipstick, I put on Carmex. The liquid Carmex, especially. I just put a little on. Just a little. That's not a little, but... just so it, when it does apply, it doesn't look like cakey, you know? I still want to look dewy and glowing and fabulous, you know? Who doesn't? Let that sit. I kiss my hand. I kiss myself. Because, you know, you have to love yourself sometimes. And that's a form of loving yourself. That's at least my form of loving myself. Which is very weird. Whatever. Okay. Ugh. Every time it gives me orgasms. Whew, Lord. It's getting there. It's getting there. Not as big as I usually draw them, but it will have to do. So I'm gonna give that a second to dry because sometimes I do the one side bigger than the other and then I have to go back in. And then sometimes it just looks like a hot mess and I have to fix some areas. The good thing about this lipstick is the more you put it on, it doesn't crumble, which is amazing because I hate when that happens. It happens honestly with the Anastasia liquid lipstick, and it happens sometimes with the Kylie lipstick, especially with the dark colors. And I think we're done. Gonna let these lips dry. So as you could tell, I overline my lips hardcore. But this is the final look. Actually, let me get dressed in the outfit that I wore in that picture, and I will be right back. Hate myself. Okay, so this is the complete final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up so I know to make more videos like this. And make sure to subscribe to see more videos in the future because you never know when my slow, lazy ass is gonna post. Oh, I have a little thing hanging out that's not cute. So definitely subscribe and turn on those notifications because girl, who's gonna be a part of that notifications? And if you do subscribe, definitely turn on the notifications to see when I'm going to post a new video. And as always, all my social media platforms is in the description down below. And yeah, I had a great time making this video and probably I'm not gonna have a great time editing it because I hate editing, but... I want to make 2017 the year to do more videos and keep to it. And girl, I'm going to try my best. No promises, but I'm going to try my best. And if you guys like these videos, I'll definitely work harder to more entertain you. And I know that I just haven't done a makeup video since like ever. So I definitely wanted to... do one now, and I hope you guys really liked it. I love you guys so much for watching. Please always stay happy, stay gorgeous, and I will see you guys in my next video. Kisses, bye. President. I'll be flying over Paris in my brand new Gucci thong, $100,000 jet with me and the squad. I'ma bounce it all day until the break of dawn. I'm never gonna stop until I reach the top. Get off my shit, get off my shit, get